Today we're going to play with using cones to help our dogs learn to do the motion patterns for the left finish in particular. We tend to judge the finish by how the dog ends up sitting next to us, but how he gets there affects what the landing looks like. And as we start off training finishes to the left, a lot of us spend time walking back and actually luring the dog into position, which is fine. We get the dog straight, but the dog's thinking about his front end and not so much about his rear end. So then when we start asking them to do it on command only, we find ourselves Phoenix heel, doing a lot of looking back to see what's happening, and the look back becomes a cue that we don't get to take with us in the ring. So I've found that for many people and dogs, using the cone helps you shape what the dog needs to do with his body a little bit better and minimize the handling. First, what I want to do is teach the dog how to move around the cone, and I don't have to do this in the context of a finish. So I can just start with the dog here and teach him to move around and chase the treat. Good boy, Danny. Here. Come. Good. Good. Get it. That's a good boy. And as they get a little better with it, we can just do tighter turns. That's a good boy. And just keep it fun. When I feel like the dog is comfortable with the cone being close, then I want to work on it as a means of forming a parking place. Okay, Phoenix, right here. Sit. Sit, please. Good. So this is going to be the parking place where I want the dog to end up. Where you stand relative to your cone will depend on the length of your dog. For him, if my toes are just a little bit ahead of the cone, Phoenix heel, the cone is placed so that it helps him remember to put his rear end straight. Okay, so having established that, I'm going to place myself really close to the cone, sit, and then I'm going to teach the dog to go around it and sidestep to open up the parking place. Heel, good, sit. That's a good boy. Dismissed, good job. Very good. And at first, with a young dog, I would spend a lot of time, sit, actually luring them around the cone, good, and making sure that they learn to actually complete the turn. Then, dismissed, when I feel like the dog is understanding the trajectory, I'm going to stop doing quite so much help. Phoenix, heel. And he has to look and get around that cone himself. Good boy, that's right. Now, if your dog has trouble with that, dismissed, then there's a stage you can go through to help them. Stay. And if necessary, actually hold them in place. Let them see the hand get there. Ready? Heel. Good. That's right. And that helps the dog think about where he's going to move. Okay, dismissed. Come. Good boy. Come front. Come front. That's the boy. But finally, I want the dog to do it on his own. Phoenix. Heel. Sidestep. Giving room to sit. Excellent dog. Cone forces him to finish the turn with his rear end. When he gets to the point that he's smooth about that, then I have the option, if I wish, to teach him to do the turn in the lane between myself and the cone. Phoenix, heel. And for him, that actually helps keep our speed. We have to play a little bit with how far I should be from the cone. Sit. Ready? Phoenix, heel. To get the sit straight. Good boy. That's right. Very good boy. Okay, dismissed. Good job. You can also use the cone to break your finishes down and back chain them. So for a dog that's uncertain, you can do this. Sit. Sit him on one side of the cone. You gotta wait, buddy. Here. Sit. Stay. And then you step up, form your parking place, heel. That's a good dog, and just work that part of the turn. Dismissed, that was very good. Let's set up again. Sit. Good boy, stay. Good. Phoenix, heel. That's the boy. And if you feel like you don't quite have the sit you want, you look at where the cone is relative to the dog. And I'm going to move myself a little closer to the cone this time, and a little further forward. Sit, stay. Good, heel. That's better, good boy. Excellent dog. Good. And when that's going well, then you can work this. Sit. So now I'm leaving him sit on the opposite side of the cone. Stay. I'm going to form my parking place. Phoenix, heel. And let him complete the turn. Excellent dog. And then work him back to the front position. I can also work with the cone to help build some smoothness on the right-hand finish. And again, I'm going to teach the dog to do that motion without me being directly involved in his position. I just wanted to do the motion pattern. Around, get it. Good boy. Here, ready? Around, get it. That's a good boy. Very good boy. Ready? Around, no. Ready? Around, get it. Good boy. That's the way. Very good. Then I can help him by sitting him right here. Stay. Place myself so the cone will help him with the landing. Around, heel. Good boy. Very nice. And even with a dog that's well trained, it's good to go back to those exercises sometimes to just work on the speed and the confidence that they have with doing the motion pattern.